So what's the deal with all these fidget spinners lately? Every kid in the neighborhood seems to have one. To some, they are a stress reliever, and to others, they are just a fun toy. You can spin them on the table. You can spin them while holding them. You can balance them while they spin. You can even stack them on top of each other while they are spinning. A good fidget spinner will continue to spin for a while on its own. Fidget spinners are about 3 inches wide and only a quarter inch thick. Let's take one apart and see what it looks like. Each of the three weights here are usually wedged in pretty tight. They can be popped out just by pushing on them. Some people like to switch these out for different weights. If they are ever unbalanced, the fidget spinner won't spin for very long. The middle is where the magic happens. You've got two caps, one on the top and one on the bottom. Use your fingernail or a flat tool to pry these off. Underneath is what they call the ball bearing. The whole point of the ball bearing is to reduce friction so it can spin for longer and faster. There are a few different parts here. The outer ring, the inner ring, the balls, and the cage to separate the balls. When it's spinning, the caps hold the inner ring in place. This part of the cap fits right inside the inner ring. The same with the bottom cap. So the caps don't spin, which means the inner ring doesn't spin. The outer ring spins along with the rest of the spinner. The balls in the middle are what allows it to spin so well. They roll along as the outer ring spins. You'll notice grooves here on both the inner and outer rings, which guide the balls. The cage keeps the balls evenly spaced apart, which holds the inner ring in place. And that's how a fidget spinner works. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. My name's Jared Owen. Thanks for watching.